Hello ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of YouTube, and welcome to the birth of a brand new Pokemon Challenge series. And how do I know it's brand new? Because this is the first video I have ever created. So a very special welcome if you're watching this now. My name is Ted, and hopefully we will be diving into a bundle of fun Pokemon related challenges. And to get this channel kicked off with a bang, instead of doing the regular old try and beat Pokemon Gold with a Caterpie or something, I've decided to go on a rather more interesting route. So get ready to enjoy the Evolution Challenge series, where we'll be comparing the different Gen 2 Evolutions and seeing which one is best. Since we're brand new, I'd love to hear what you think of this first ever video, so please comment down below, even if you think it's rubbish. But if you enjoyed what you're seeing so far, or at any stage during the video, please like, subscribe, share this content with your friends. There's so much more to come, I promise. So anyway, to kick this all off, I've chosen my favourite Evolution, Espeon, or Bestpeon, because frankly, it's the best Evolution. It looks the coolest, and it's the best because it's Psychic type. You know, it's even better than those new ones in the later games. You know, I've always loved Psychic type as well. Something about blasting your enemies with your mind because of how smart you are just appealed to me, I suppose. That's a dream. So anyway, as I'm starting this challenge off, I suspect the major brick walls, there probably won't be many, but I'm not looking forward to Karen or Will in the Elite Four, but I think everything else is going to be hunky-dory. But anyway, before we start, let's go over the rules. It's standard stuff here. Espeon only in battle, HM slaves are A-OK, and no items in battle. Rock and roll. Let's go. So we start off by naming our guy Ted, obviously, because this is about me, and our Espeon, Stephion, after my lovely girlfriend and first subscriber to my channel, Steph. So the first thing I noticed though is that for a special attacking Pokemon, our attack stat is rubbish, and we don't get a special attacking move until level 16, which is confusion. Not a problem though, we'll just have to make do with Tackle. So we'll skip over all the boring and unimportant bits and we'll go straight to giving our rival the beatdown with some hot tackling action. Our rival of course has stolen himself a Totodile from the lovely Professor Realm, so we're not going to let that slide, we're not going to let this guy get away with thievery. We're a 10-year-old child. He's gotten a crit on us, so I'm still confident that we can get him. Down to 4 HP, okay, alright, no, we let him get away, but I am going to get my sweet, sweet revenge by giving his name as Pencils to the local authority, which is, you know, I'm a mature man. It was going to be something else. The older ones among you can probably work out what it was going to be. Anyway, we take out our frustrations on this top percentage Rattata, and as you can imagine, the world should hold no fears for me and my Espeon as we make our way over to do a little bit of grinding at Sprout Tower against the fearsome Sage Lee. Sage Lee, of course, is a trainer I've beaten many times in my many years of playing this particular game, and it looks like it's going to go that way again. Absolutely no problems whatsoever. Oh. Okie dokies. What about... No. Okay. Two times. Come on. Three times. Three times, Sage Lee. Haha, got ya. Okay, so we did beat him eventually, and then we take our fury out on Falconer. I am stupidly over-leveled at this point, and I do apologise for that, but it was the only way I could beat the fearsome Sage Lee! Anyway, that is a bit of a theme for the rest of the video, and I am deeply, deeply sorry. I should have just come straight to the gym, but never mind. We beat Falconer, and then we come to Hiker Russell, and I've taught Espeon, well, Stephpeon, I've taught Stephpeon Mudslap for this very occasion. And as you can see, I've used the PP very wisely by running out for his third Geodude, which is level 8. I try and tackle it down after a bunch of tail whips, but just miss out. He clutches the victory. Anyway, I do get my revenge eventually. Slowpoke, well, nothing to worry about. We're on to Bugsy. We've got Confusion. I don't really see this going close at all. This isn't Sage Lee we're dealing with here, guys. It's just Bugsy, and we win. Easy peasy. Pencil's back again. He's got a Ghastly. I've got an Espeon, mate. Off your trot. Zubat? Same way, mate. Croconaw? Hopefully it doesn't learn Bite yet. Good, it's still on Scratch. Easy peasy. Lemon squeezy. Whitney is going to be easy, I hope, as well. See, look, it's simple, mate. Clefairy? No damage, 2 times. I don't need heals. Miltank's only using Stomp. I've got... Oh my good... Not... Seriously? Didn't even use Rollout and it got me. Right, okay, I'm going in fully healed this time. No, I went in for... I've got less HP than last time from when I battled Miltank. Ah, good gravy. Right, alright, it's another loss then. Ha ha! 1 HP! I was really hoping it was going to hit itself in confusion, but that works too. I'll take it. Anyway, we're on to Equatique City in the Burnt Tower. We've got Haunter. One shot, off your trot. Croconaw? Oh no, Nosebite. Well, this is why I gave him Croconaw in the first, well, Totodile in the first place, so he could learn Bite, so I could give myself a challenge, because this has been pretty easy so far, apart from Sage Lee and Hiker Russell. Yes, you wouldn't have dreamed it. When you clicked on this video, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, you wouldn't have dreamed that Sage Lee from the Sprout Tower and Hiker Russell in Union Cave would be the troublesome ones, but here we go. Morty, it was always going to go this way, surely, with Espeon against a load of poison ghosts. Super effective, confusion, one shot's a lot, off your trot, nice one. However, looking at Kimono Girl with her Umbreon, just remember that Pokemon in the top right hand corner, just under where it says bandicam.com, is going to be a brick wall later. Well, it's not going to be a brick, not Umbreon itself, but it's going to be part of a brick wall. Oh, hang on a sec. Knob. Anyway, on to Chuck. You know, this is how fast we're going. Ain't nothing going to stop us now, ladies, gentlemen, boys and girls, apart from maybe this Poliwrath. Oh god, he's put me to sleep. Oh, well, it's over. Got him. Oh, that was brilliant. I love it. Okay, Jasmine, we fed the Ampharos. We got the medicine. You know, we're a 10-year-old kid. That's what we do. Right, Magneton. Paralyze? No, don't do this. Jasmine, yeah, see? That's what's supposed to happen. The Magnemite fate. Can you not? Okie dokie. Well, I'm not used to whiting out, obviously, so, you know, trying to look at my Pokemon. I remember I'm on a solo challenge. It's no big deal. We'll go back to Jasmine. Jasmine, easy peasy lemon squeezy this time. You're not going to get no paralysis on me. You're not going to get no supersonic on me. See? Didn't affect. Oh, don't paralyze. Oh, come on. Oh, I'm not fully Well, I am 29 HP better off than last. Okay, never mind. Right, we're going to skip this. We're going to go and get... Oh my god, it's a shiny Gyarados. You guys, I've got a shiny. No way. Can't believe it. That has never happened to me ever before. We do go and grab Hidden Power because I've seen in Pokemon videos that it's useful sometimes. Price, listen, mate. I don't rate your chances. Okay? We're here to win. We're just going to go ahead and do it. See? Seal, one shot. Dewgong. Alright, 2 shots. And a pitiful amount of damage from Headbutt. What are you playing at, Price? You're a gym leader. You're a gym leader. Never mind the fact I'm overleveled. Please, I just did the Rocket Hideout. It's just full of XP. There's no way around it. You've got to get it. Especially on a solo run. Anyway, we're back to Jasmine. I've got Psybeam now. I'm just going to brute force my way through it. Because quite frankly, she has it coming. Right, got that sorted out. Oh, hit and confusion. Thunderbolt. Paralyzed. Confused. Come on, just get it down. There we go. Right, onto Steelix. One shot, please. I got one shot. Okay, look, we'll try again. And if that, I'll go. I've been off the cuff for a little while now, guys. I'll give you this. I'll battle Jasmine about 20 times. Just thinking I could brute force it. This is the first time ever in Pokemon that I've had to really try and devise a strategy to beat a boss. Like, I tried Shadow Ball. I tried all sorts of other things. But I'm going to check what Hidden Power is now. If you're not sure about Hidden Power is it is a move whose type is dependent on, like, I think it's like your trainer ID or your IVs or your EVs. But don't expect a professional thing here. Like, I'm not J-Rose or Madrybread or anything like that. It's my first day, leave me alone, right? But anyway, it's random what type it'll be. Anyway, it does the job. It does it. It's super effective. I reckon it's ground type. I'm fairly sure it's ground type. And we get rid of Magnemite, and we get rid of other Magnemite. One shot, does the job, off you trot. Steelix, on the other hand, seems to like this hidden power. That's why I think it's ground, because it evolves from Onix, and I'm fairly sure that's what the deal is. Psybeam does the damage anyway. 3 shot. All right, maybe not 3 shot. There's a third. Fourth. Hey, she's out of hyper potions. Banging. Some of you may have just heard my phone go off. I'm going to have to stop the recording now to check if it did go off on the thing. So yeah, the good news is I didn't hear my phone go off, so we're keeping this party professional apparently. That's pretty good. I've lost my place in the script having to do that, but never mind. It's pencils time. He's coming at me. He's got his Sneasel. It's a dark type. I'm not going to hit him very hard with Psybeam at all. I've got Quick Attack, I've got Hidden Power, they both seem to be doing the same thing, so I mix it up a little bit, why shouldn't I? Anyway, smash the Four Alligator with Psybeam, easy peasy. He's got Bite, I'm getting pretty low on health. I'm not worried at all though, because it's just Magnemite, and we know how to deal with them now, easy peasy. Haunter, Psybeam, easy, nice. So yeah, I know, like, it's pretty boring, like, because I'm this overleveled. But, like, we've got the Rocket Executive. You know, I'm trying to keep it interesting. I've not healed in ages, apparently. I can't... Do you know what? I recorded this about a week ago, and I'm doing the script, and I'm trying to find still where I am in the script. You know, from earlier, when I said I didn't know where I was in the script, I still don't know where I am in the script. This is... ad lib. Right here, but there's Mr. Director, and he's thrilled. He is so thrilled that I've saved his radio tower, the 10-year-old boy. Obviously, you know, Officer Jenny doesn't exist anymore, but there is that guard down by the daycare, and he attacks you if it's nighttime, and he's obviously earning his paycheck very well. But anyway, so we smashed through the ice path. I ran out of repels halfway through. It was an absolute nightmare. It's not the first time in this video I've run out of repels. I'm just lazy and, you know, I'll just run. It's quicker than getting the... it's not quicker than getting the repels. Anyway, we're in the gym. Beating up some Dratinis. There's our first taste of dragon power. It wasn't powerful at all, but here we've got Claire. And if I remember rightly, I didn't heal for Claire, but it doesn't seem to matter. But I misclicked. I clicked Psybeam instead of Psychic. So that Dragonair has got off the paralysis. And we know from previous battles how much I don't like paralysis, don't we, team? But Psychic's doing the job. I'm level 48 now. I've got 8 levels on Hyper Beam. Okay, yeah, I was going to say that Kingdra didn't stand a chance. But this time, I'm not going to click Psybeam. I'm going to click Psychic, and it's going to be easy. Let's just count it down. Number 1. Boom. Number 2. Boom. Number 3. Boom! Level 48, loving it. Ah, just shy of the one shot. And a hyper potion with a smoke screen. I think we all know what way this... Yep, there's the miss. Ah, there we go. Ah, sorted. Claire. Yeah, I'm not gonna smack talk Claire here at this stage. Because, like, you know... I'm well over leveled for this. Luckily, like, it does kind of level out once we get to the Pokemon League. Here's Claire giving me my badge after she illegally makes me go and fetch her a Dragon Claw or Dragon Fang, whatever it was. Anyway, it's so uninteresting at this stage that we just skip straight to the end of Victory Road and we do the little battle with Pencils, the man of the hour. Sends out a Sneasel, it gets wrecked, sends out his Golbat, it gets wrecked, but yeah, you know, there's 15-ish levels between us all. Magneton does get out the paralysis, and I'm worried now, but oh, I'm confused as well. It's the classic combo, ladies and gentlemen, back to Jasmine, we're getting throwbacks. Fully paralysed, I'm hitting myself in confusion, it's hit me with a curse, it's getting the Shadow Ball cheese. Here we go, Kadabra. What can I do? I mean, like, I think I know at this stage it's a foregone conclusion, this. Yeah, fully paralysed, there's the faint. So, yeah, that didn't go well, and that's pretty worrying for this stage of the game, because I really should be able to beat my rival pretty easily, but, you know, we're doing the old easy street. We're going for return, and we get rid of Psybeam, and... I was pulling my beard out, trying to figure out which move to get rid of there, and I went for Psybeam. I needed the PP for the Elite Four. I've got a couple of ethers. Before I start the Elite Four, I'm going to go and get more, because I'm going to need them. And we get the luck there on Magneton. I don't know if you saw that. He went for Thunder Wave. completely missed. Well, it didn't affect me, because Espeon is so brilliant. So yeah, it's an easy win now at this stage. I don't think there's anything that can really happen. For Alligator's too slow. Easy peasy. Pencils, you have been rubbish apart from that one battle where you got lucky and critted. Not even a rival, to be quite honest, but I'd say that's my fault. Anyway, there's Espeon. We got stats, we got moves, and here's Will. We're going for the psychic showdown. It's time. If anyone's ever seen South Park, like all I think of when I hear psychic showdown is Cartman and those psychic detectives who are like, "Oh no, you had to take the course from the back of the comic book." And then Cartman's like, no, I got my psychic powers from a horrific accident. And then they start going, pew, 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 just like in the middle of the room. Cartman's mum's like diving behind the sofa, taking cover. And I'm talking about this because Will is really hard to beat with just an Espeon without the right moves and without the right luck. So he wiped the floor with us there quite easily. Like, I don't think I saw the whole team. I think... Yeah, he's sending out Slowbro last, and that's really annoying because he's got enough time to get up like screens and reflex and all sorts of status against my one Pokemon. I'm going to try Iron Tail because I need something that can take out the Jinx first time. I'm not sure why I was too concerned about, to be honest, because I don't think Jinx really did that much to me last time. Anyway, we smash out Zatu with return. We take a little bit of damage. 16 damage, easy peasy. And then there's this conundrum. Do I learn Morning Sun? I think for this time, I'm just going to see how it goes without Morning Sun. Because I never really bother with healing moves, because the damage is just going to get done next turn. Anyway, Zatu cheeses us with the old confusion. We're on to Jinx. We're going to try out Iron Tail. Hey, that was worthwhile. Learn an Iron Tail. Let's give Iron Tail another go on this Exeggutor. Oh, it's not gone well. We're missing, and he put up a defense thing, and I'm still using a physical attack. Like, how stupid do you have to be, Ted? Like, come on. Come on. Anyway, we've got Slowbro here on the go, and we're kind of chipping away, but it gets us with the Body Slam. It was a no-go at that low HP, so I'm going to try it again. I'm going to try again with low HP. But I think what I do this time, and correct me if I'm wrong, smash out the Zatu, and I think I teach myself Morning Sun, because I've not got Iron Tail on at the moment. So let's just see. Zatu was easy pickings there, and that one, but like I'm down almost at half health. I go for Return on Jinx, it's almost a one-shot, but it misses a lovely kiss. All as well in the world. Go for Return on Exeggutor. It's got a lot of defense. It's got Leech Seed up. Egg Bomb. 35 HP for Slowbro. But Morning Sun. Morning Sun. Could this be the most perfectly timed heal in the history of Pokemon? It's used Amnesia. We've got another heal. Leech Seed is causing some problems now. Return is doing absolutely nothing with that Leech Seed. It's not going to work. No, there it is. Confirmation Station. It didn't work. So yeah, I think I don't want to go and level anymore. Like I said earlier, I don't really pay too much attention to strategy with Pokemon games. The way I've always played it is have a team of overleveled Pokemon and then one-shot everything. So doing a challenge run, for me at this stage, like, this is all new. But anyway, we're going through. We're doing a little bit more damage on Exeggutor. Psychic, not very effective. Did the job. Now, Special Defense with Amnesia has gone up. We're going with Return. We're getting there. We're almost there. Come on, Espeon. Come on. 1 HP. Yes! Wow. Oh my goodness, that was close. We've had a couple of really close calls on this run, and that is why I'm so... like interested and intrigued with this run. Like, I've never this is the first time I've ever done a solo Pokemon challenge run, and it is just you think you know everything about it, and then you come and do a challenge because you saw it on YouTube, and wow, like, it's really kept me interested, and that's why I was able to do this so quickly. Like, I filmed this in like a couple of hours. What with mistakes and everything like that. Oh no, I didn't get the fastest speed going. I've seen speed runs, like, people do it properly and they get, like, Johto and Kanto done and read in like 2.5 hours or something like that. I think my final time on this was like 7 hours in-game time, but I did leave it paused for quite a long time. Anyway, you realise I've spoken straight over Koga, and that's because it doesn't really bear thinking about. Same with Bruno, to be honest. Like, I'm super effective against all his Pokemon bar Onix. I do make pretty bad play with Onix. I try Hidden Power, and it just does nothing because it's Hidden Power. And he gets up a Sandstorm, so it's doing chip damage on me. I'm like, oh god, if one of Bruno's Pokemon gets a decent hit on me, I'm done. I am done. And there's my champ. But it's alright, because I'm Psychic type. What a fool, having Fighting type Pokemon. There we go. Oh well. Bye-bye, Hitmonlee. There we go. See you, Bruno. Sweet. So, up next, we have the brickiest brick wall. If you were looking at this wall, it's called Karen. Oh, that music. Oh, I love this song. Anyway, I have absolutely no idea how I'm going to beat Karen at this stage. I should have been thinking about it a while ago. I think I'm just like, do you know what? Just use Return and see what happens. It's a powerful enough move. Espeon's got rubbish attack, doesn't it? So, like, Umbreon gets up the status. And that's it, pretty much. Like, I'm missing almost every attack. I'm not even close to one-shotting the old Murkrow. But I'm going to try again. Like, make sure I've got enough returns to do the whole battle this time. That is a very good idea. And I save after that because I know I'll forget the next time I wipe out. So yeah, this is why I showed Umbreon earlier on in the video. Like, there was that one bit with the Kamino girl with Umbreon. And it's such a brick wall. I dislike it so much. And it's probably going to be my next video. I just can't get that Murkrow. That Murkrow is causing me all manner of problems, but let's see. Hidden Power doesn't even do half. Crunch finishes me off. Yeah, this is too hard. But I've got a rare candy. And that might just help with just getting that Murkrow down. So that'll just give me a little bit more health, because it's always using Faint Attack. Faint Attack can't miss, for those of you who don't know. Sand Attack is really annoying for a move that you can have, like, from level 5, right? And the only reason I'm not using Sand Attack is because it's going to be bloody pointless, because Umbreon will still get all the Sand Attacks. I need to get that down ASAP. I need to get it gone. Ooh, 2 crits. Come on. Oh, it's just Gengar and Vileplume. I've got... Oh, don't miss. Oh, no, not Curse. All right, yeah, easy peasy. Right, just hit the Vileplume. No, no, don't miss. No, no, nah, not paralyzed. No, not again. No. Are you joking? Are you serious? Karen! Anyway, there was a bunch of tries after that. I tried everything. I tried getting Raw so I could get rid of the Umbreon. Apparently Espeon can't learn Raw. Fair enough. So I'm gonna go with Attract, just to see if I can stall out a couple of moves and maybe clinch a victory. Squeaky bum time, everyone. We've got the Attract, we've got the cheese. Failed Sand Attack, absolutely yes. Come on. Oh no, not Confuse Ray. Come on. Oh no. Oh yes. Infatuation kept it from attacking. That is a phrase I love seeing now. Come on. Return. Oh, so close. Alright, I'm doing well. 91 HP for Houndoom. Come on. Yes. Yes. Alright, okay, right. Can we get the Gengar? Yes. Yes, we can. Vileplume, come on, don't miss. Yes! Brilliant. Oh, I never want to see that sprite ever again. Ever. That was annoying. Like, because you didn't see it. You guys, like, you know, I talked through a couple of failed attempts that you saw. You didn't see all of them. And you are welcome. You can thank me in the comments. Cheers. So yeah, anyway, Lance time. And do you know what? Ugh. That's a glitch. Alright, yeah. Lance time. I think I've got this. I think it's going to be pretty simple. I'm going to hit Psychic a lot. Okay, yeah. Downpour. Easy peasy. Gyarados. No HP loss. Level 56. Boom. Dragonite. Oh, it's not one shot. Oh, no. Not Paralysis again. Oh, goodness. Okay. Okay. Can I clutch this out? Nah, it's not gonna happen, is it? No, okay, yeah, alright. I was overconfident. I'll give you that. I thought it was gonna be pretty easy, but you know what I'm gonna do? Put Psychic at the top, because that's gonna help things. Here we go again. Gyarados, Psychic, one shot? Nah, still not one shot. Can never get a crit when I need it. Right, awesome, level 56. I like that amount of HP. I'm gonna try Attract this time round. See if that happens. Oh, there it is again. Infatuation, kept it from attacking, and there's a crit. Nice one, I like that. Let's Attract again. Easy peasy, infatuation. Mwah, mwah. I'm sending you all the kisses. Mwah, mwah, mwah. Yes, right, Aerodactyl, what do I do? Do I Attract, or do I just go straight in for the Psychic? I think I can take it. Boom, critical hit as well. We don't know if it was going to be a one-shot anyway. It doesn't matter. It probably wouldn't have been because it didn't take out Charizard, but he's only done like 23 damage with a slash. Oh, and there it is again. We get the return because I think like Psychic's probably just going to knock it down a little bit too much, and then we'll get the full restore. And a Psychic in the next turn. We done did it. We done did it, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. There's Mary. There's Professor Oak. They're going to muck around, and Lance is going to take me into the Hall of Champions. We've done it. But, you know it's Pokemon Gold, right? You know there's something else we got to do. And it's Kanto, first off. And it is this stupid. Just talk amongst yourselves, everyone, just while I smash out Kanto. A couple of trainer battles. Sabrina, oh, talk about Sabrina. Another Psychic showdown, and it's another brick wall, because I kept missing all of my attacks. And when I keep missing my attacks, Alakazam takes me out. What's the... Right, I'm going to try again with Attract. Brilliant. But it's so stupid because I keep missing everything, as you do. I think there's some sand attack cheese in there from Sabrina's Espeon. Mr. Mime goes down after just a battle of attrition, and here's Alakazam. Almost dead. Come on. No. Almost dead. Come on. Oh my goodness. Oh no, there's no PP. Come on. Die. Die. Die! Yes. Got ya. Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you enjoyed that brief little interlude, courtesy of Benny Hill. So, yeah, we're at the top of Mount Silver. Only one guy left. Not this Golbat. Go away. This is why I should buy more repels. Anyway, save the game now so I don't get that Golbat every time, because you just know that would happen, knowing my luck. Anyway, I've learnt my lesson. I'm going to go straight for Attract. Right, get the Psychic. Maybe I shouldn't have gone for the Attract first time. Pikachu is nothing to me. Anyway, we get the attract on Espeon. We're hoping for the cheese, but that charm has seriously damaged our attack. So we go with Psychic. It's not very effective, but it's doing so much more. And I caught Snorlax with the Master Ball, obviously, because what else would you use a Master Ball for? And so yeah, I've got the leftovers now, but here is the next wall. The brickiest brick wall since a brick wall named Karen brick walled me in a brick wall making contest back in Indigo Plateau. Snorlax is a beast and is unkillable, but I have an idea. I'm going to use Toxic, right? And this is going to be my cheese, because for the first time apart from the beginning of the game, I'm underleveled, right? So it's a real challenge. It's a real challenge now. So Pikachu, we're back out. Hidden power's gone. So Psychic, straight on it. Attract, Espeon, infatuation, that's what we like. Poison. Nice one. So we've got that chip damage coming on. We could do a bit more with the old return. We've not had a charm. Our attack's looking good. Well, it's better than it was last time. Brilliant. Get the level up. Snorlax time. Straight in with Attract. We don't want any cheese. He's cheesing us. He's got the amnesia. Okay, so it's... Oh, Body Slam. Oh, Paralysis. Well, this isn't going well. Okie dokie. Right, let's try again. Do you know what? I believe in Attract. And I also believe in the Pink Bow. We're getting rid of the leftovers because they're just not helping us that much. Snorlax can just do too much damage. We need to be doing more damage. Get rid of Hidden Power again. Get Toxic. I should have saved after there, but your boy's an idiot. Never mind. Pikachu, off you trot. Nice one. Espeon, Attract. Ugh. Okay, right. We'll get it next time. Let's get that. Oh, Reflect. Okay, the defense is up. Never mind. Just carry on. Oh, a crit. That's nice. I wouldn't have minded a crit on Snorlax. That would have been nice. Espeon, if you don't mind. Never mind. We get the Attract. We get the Infatch. We got the Tox. We got the Psy. It's going well. Oh, he's used Amnesia. Right. Really sorry. My Bandicam does 10-minute things. Does 10-minute recording sprees. And I realised after I killed Snorlax that it had stopped recording. So I do apologise. I did get it down legitimately. Much like I got down Charizard just there. Attract is the real MVP of this fight. I am so close to winning this game. Level 66 Espeon, come on. Oh, that was close. Oh, right, if I can hit the Venusaur, it's super effective because he's poison. If I get this, I win. No! Yes! Ah, what a fool! Solar Beam, what a saviour. Oh my goodness, and we've won. Look at that. Victory has been achieved. Well done, team. We got through it together. And yeah, I can't believe it. I can't believe that I've finally done my first Pokemon solo challenge. And what an experience it was. Like, I didn't realise I could have that much fun with a game I've not played properly in about... How old am I now? 20 years? Something like that? I don't know. It could have been 20 years. It could be less than that. Maybe 15. Who knows? Anyway. That was great. Mind blown. So yeah, hopefully the next Pokemon I'll be using will offer the same amount of challenge, or maybe even push my limits further. But I just want to thank you all so much for watching. If you've made it this far, from the very bottom of my heart, thank you so much. Please, if you haven't already, please give me a thumbs up or a subscribe or a share to your mates. Please comment down below if you enjoyed it. Equally, if you didn't enjoy it, comment down below. My videos are only going to get better from this point on. So yeah, I'll be aiming to upload more videos, more challenges coming up. So I'll be aiming to upload these every Thursday night. GMT for all my American buds out there. So figure out what GMT is to you, or just watch it on Thursday morning or Friday. I don't know how it works. I'm not a clock. I'm Firebeard. Name's Ted. Thanks once again. Cheerio.